everyone, it's Jen, and I am here today to do a flip through of the new calendar by Kelly O'Gorman. This is the 2020 calendar, and you may remember last year I showed the 2019 calendar, and I absolutely loved it. I've colored several of the pictures from that, and what's awesome about these calendars is you don't have to color them by the month. You can color them whenever you want to. So I just color that whenever I'm in the mood to color something from there. I think I've colored about 5 pictures from there now. And I have colored a picture in here as well. I decided after all the reviews and everything that I had done this year that I wanted to color a Christmas picture right towards the end of Christmas. So I colored the 2020 Christmas picture from here, which you will see when we get through the flip through. But Kelly contacted me and told me she was going to be sending me one of these when it was printed, because she is just a wonderful artist. Wait till you see the work in here. It is her best so far, in my opinion, and I love this so much. And she so generously has provided one for a giveaway. So the giveaway, the book is going to come directly from Kelly. So this is going to be open internationally. So you, whoever wins, will be winning one of these calendars directly from Kelly, and I'm sure she will sign it for you as she signed mine here. So let's go ahead and look through the calendar. So this is a, it's a long calendar. So instead of it being wide like last year's, it's much more lengthwise. I can't think of the word I'm looking for, but it's like, instead of, it's like legal pad. That would be a good way to describe it. So we have the beautiful cover, which you could absolutely color if you wanted to. It's on like a matte paper, so you would have the option to do that. Now on the other side, you have your full length picture, and I will bring it closer so you can see it. And in this one, she included the word January, if you can see it in the top there. And there's several touches like that in each one of these books. And look at the little elf or whatever he is there in the little tree. Isn't that cute? And you have the little snail. And then another little elf here, super adorable. I love this calendar. I mean, it is just stunning. Now, this does have, I think, the UK dates and things on it, so you might have to be careful about that. I don't know if it's really any different than the American one. I know last year's was, but I don't actually use these for the calendar. I use it to color. So here we have a gorgeous whale. And it says love for February. Very appropriate, and you can see the whale is in the shape of a heart. So you have his little tail here, and then the water kicking up. Very, very creative and inventive and beautiful. And you have some hearts here too. Kelly put so much work into this, and I think it's phenomenal. So here we have March, and we have the I don't know if she's like a goddess or what she is, but we have the rabbit and March there. And these are printed on white paper. It's a nice thick cardstock type of paper. And it is, of course, spiral bound since it is a calendar, and you do have the option to hang this up if you want to. So you could create your pictures and hang them up each month in your office or your craft space or wherever you like. So for April, we have a beautiful, I mean, this is so cool because it's not only spring stuff that she's included in here, but we have our bunny rabbits and the chicks. And they're laying their little eggs. We also have some Easter eggs here and the flowers. Gorgeous. Love this so much. Perfect for Easter and for spring. She really, really made them theme like this year, which I think is really awesome. So what are we up to here? May. So May, we have sort of like a steampunk. Let me just move the light a little bit so you can see a little bit better. We have a steampunk theme. And I mean, this is gorgeous. The picture is so big, and I have used watercolors on these before without a problem at all. You can use your markers. If you're going to use it as a calendar, you probably don't want to do it ahead. Well, actually, I guess it wouldn't be a problem because it's on the picture is on the month behind, so you should be okay with it if you want to do it like a month behind. But you can use anything if you're not going to use it as a calendar. But these are so fun to color. I have used all my different pencils on these and not had a problem with them at all. All right, what are we up to now? I keep forgetting the months. We're up to June. So here we have some fruits, and then underneath we have the little people living underground, and I don't know what they are, but they're super cute, and I guess they want the fruits. I don't know. I'm not sure what's going on here, but either way, those guys are really adorable and so fun to color. And Kelly's even put some sort of like some shading in so that you, if you really didn't want to do any shading, you really wouldn't have to, because it's already in there for you. All right, so now we're up to July, and this is my birthday month. So here we have the nautical lady that is on the cover, and she's super beautiful. I mean, she has seahorses and fish and coral and star shells. That's what I was going to say, but that's not right. the stars, I can't think of my brain. Just don't mind me, people. She's got like an eel, she's got shells, she's got, what's this little guy here? She's got a snail, she's got seashells, she's got horns, she even has some tentacles, she has a seashell necklace. Gorgeous, gorgeous. There's so much work that went into this, and that is going to be so fun to color in the summertime because it's really, really nautical. All right. For August, we have a little girl walking through the woods, it looks like. And if you take a look, we have all kinds of, I'm sorry, it keeps dropping on me, it's because it's large. We have all little creatures here. Even one poking out in there, you can see the tree has a face. Looks like she has a little bird in her hands, and you have some of the little maybe gnomes or tree goblins or whatever they are looking at her. So really what I like about them is they're not scary looking. They're really kind of cute, just saying. All right, moving on to September. So here we have a really, really beautiful, it looks like a forest scene, and of course we're moving into fall, so you can start creating your fall colors and your reds and your oranges, your browns. Of course you could do anything you like with it, but that's probably what I would do. Also here we have the faces in the trees, so you could really make it kind of like a Halloween-y type thing if you want to. You have some people poking out looking at you over there, and you have the word September at the bottom. Moving on to October, we have a real Halloween picture, which is so cool. Look at this, you guys. Let me show you the far out one, and then I'll bring it up closer so you can see it. So inside the skull, you have, like, I don't know if that's a bat or a cat. It's probably a bat, but I don't see any wings, but it has vampire teeth, so there you go. It also has some ghosts up there. There is a little bat at the top. Then you have a witch, two witches here and here, like around the eyes. You have a tree that is the nose, which is so cool. And you have the witch's feet. Then you have some like Frankenstein hands here, or whatever you want to make them as. And then you have a little pumpkin patch in the bottom. So isn't that cool? I love coloring themed things, so I'm super excited to do this. I'm definitely going to use some watercolors on this, probably to do like the bigger portions of the face, and then I don't know what I'm going to do. We'll see, but I'm so excited to color this. All right, moving on to November. So November, we have another, she's kind of like what do they call them? Flora, fauna kind of things. She's kind of like a woodsy type deer creature, I would say. We have some squirrels here, and then you have the girl. She has some beautiful horns with flowers and little birds and things coming out of them. Really, really nice. And some grass and stuff over here, or you could make it a jacket, whatever you want to do. It's up to you. But isn't that pretty? So beautiful. And then we are in the last page, which is December, and this is the one that I colored. So here we have a beautiful angel, and inside her beautiful skirt, we have all kinds of Christmas things, like an elf, a penguin, some ornaments, a nutcracker, Rudolph, an angel, and two little snowmen, some candy canes. And I think you can see I stickled this up pretty good. I colored with all different pencils on this. Holbeins, Prismacolors, Luminance, Polychromos, Faber, Gold Fabers, and was there anything else? That might have been it for this one. I also used watercolors on this one, and I put, actually, these are the designs by Karen watercolors. So these are the holographic ones. I don't know how well you can really see them on here. I'm trying to shine the light to show you. But there's also Stickles on here. And there's Wink of Stella. So I'm showing you all this to show you that, as you can see, the page isn't warped at all, even though I used the watercolors on it. It totally did not go through to the other page. And you have, I mean, it's gorgeous. It's wonderful paper to work on. It's got a nice tooth to it. I loved coloring this. I had so much fun. This is my last Christmas picture that I did for the season. So I'm really happy with it and love coloring in these. So then you have, obviously, your last page in December, and that is it. And then you have a little sample on the back of all of the pictures for the year. So I highly recommend these calendars. If you don't have one, I believe you can get the PDF from her Etsy shop, as well as the printed out one, if you should like it. I always like to have the printed out ones of these things. But as I said, Kelly so graciously has offered to do a giveaway for this. So I'm going to be opening up the giveaway for this as soon as the video has gone live. So as soon as you're seeing this, the giveaway is open. The giveaway is going to run for 2 weeks. So today is the 13th, and this is going to run till January 27th, 2020. So after 11:59, if you have not gotten your comment in, once it hits 12 a.m., then that is the last for the comments. So what you have to do is leave a comment in this video below and tell me what picture struck you and what you'd like to color first if you got this calendar. Would you like to start from the beginning and go through each month? Would you just color things as, like I do, just randomly as the feeling strikes you? What would you do? So leave that information down below in the comments. Now, in order to enter, you need to be a subscriber of the Reading with Pugs channel. You need to be 18 years or older. So please, if you were under 18, do not enter the contest. Also, you have to be okay with me giving your address to Kelly so that she can ship it to you. As I said, this is open internationally, so everyone is welcome to enter. The way that I will choose the winner is I will put all of the comments into random.org, and I will let random.org pick the comment number, and then I will contact that person through YouTube, and that would be in the comments. So I've had a lot of questions lately saying, oh, I didn't see a winner announced and all that kind of thing. I do not announce the winners on my channel. And the reason that I don't do that is because if I announce that, anybody could contact me and say they are that person. How am I to know that they are that person? So what I do is, when I choose the winner, I go ahead and I heart your comment, and then I will comment back to you and ask you to contact me with your information. So you have to have your comments on and be able to get a comment back from me in order to win. I will give you 48 hours once I comment back to you and let you know that you are the winner. If you don't respond to me, I remove the comment and I will pick someone else. So again, you must have your comments open. If you don't ever hear from me, let's say a week after the contest is over, then you most likely didn't win. But as long as you have your comments on, you will know if you are the winner or not. So I think that takes care of everything. I will wish good luck to all the people that enter the contest, and a big, big thank you to Kelly for sending this and setting up the giveaway for us. She's super generous. She has amazing coloring books. She's got a few coloring books and she has some calendars. Please go check out her Etsy store. I will leave the information in the description below. And I think that's it. So I want to take the time to thank you for taking the time to watch today, and I will see you real soon.